fight coming up next. It's a UFC heavyweight showdown. Well, it's always exciting when you have such a high-level Brazilian jiu-jitsu practitioner. This man has been a master of the submission in the UFC, and even though a lot of people know what's coming, more often than not, they're unable to stop.
Because the knowledge of the jiu-jitsu game is truly something that it's hard to replicate when a guy is as good as he is. I mean, he will jump for a triangle. He will jump for an armbar, and as you slam him to the ground, he starts to understand, okay, I'm right where I need you right now. This is when the game starts for him. If he doesn't secure that submission, he gets you where he needs you to be in order to start to really make you drown. It's like going in deep water and getting pulled down over and over again, because every time you think, if I do this, it'll make it better, it just makes it worse.
And best of luck trying to find a training partner to simulate this guy in the gym.
It can't happen, and it won't happen.
All right, so here he is, one of the more prolific takedown artists in the UFC at present. And when you get some praise from Daniel Cormier when it comes to your offensive takedown game, you know you're doing something right.
And we talk about wrestlers and judo players and grapplers, but this guy just combines all of that. He is able to use foot sweeps from the grappling game. He is able to use throws from judo, and he's able to use wrestling from the wrestling game to take people down. He has an array of takedowns at his disposal, and he uses every single one of them, from the speed of the level change to the timing to the knowledge of where to go next. When the guy starts to defend, he's truly, truly something special.
I don't think he could take you down, but tonight he doesn't have to. So
he does not
in
have
this
to.
Matchup, prevailing wisdom is he'll be able to get this fight to the canvas.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the main event of the evening. And when the action begins, our referee in charge, Dan Mergliotta. And now, this is the moment UFC fans around the world have been waiting for. Live from the sold-out arena in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. This man is a freestyle fighter, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 6'6" tall, weighing in at 265 pounds. Fighting out of Minneapolis, Minnesota, Butcher. And now introducing his opponent, fighting out of the red corner. This man is a kickboxer, making his professional debut here tonight. He stands 5'9" tall, weighing in at 154 pounds. Fighting out of Las Vegas, Nevada, Assassin!
All right, commit to the rules of the locker room. I want you to obey my commands at all times, protect yourself at all times. I want a nice, clean, safe fight. Touch gloves, back your corners, come out fighting.
Well, always great to be back in the MMA hotbed that is Rio de Janeiro as we get underway here at the Juness Arena in Brazil. Well, perhaps a sign of things to come as he lands a kick there.
Nice kick landed by this gentleman.
Lands with the kick there, no pad on that foot.
No shin guard, he's taking all of that kick every time he throws. Big punch to the body.
Well, we talked about his reach advantage off the top. Made good use of it there with that punch, DC. All right, he'll engage in a single collar tie.
Oh, nice right hand, John.
Man, he's just got a great feel for the striking realm early in this one.
The timing is on point. He's doing a great job of mixing everything up. Nice head kick. Good punch. Look at those weapons. Look at how he uses his knees to the body.
And they're exchanging leather early. He's got a serious right punch, and he went to it effectively there.
It is a money shot, and he will continue to throw it until he finds a knockout.
Oh, nice counter to land the left hook there.
Big kick land.
just misses with the left hook. Oh, nice straight there. I guess that's the quickest way to the target, right? Just throw straight.
Straight down is always best. Good stick. I mean, he's cutting down the size with these beautiful leg kicks.
Oh, nice. He loaded up on that right hand, too.
Oh, collar tie. Now going upstairs with the left hook. Big right hook coming. It's blocked. Oh, and the gentleman lands another punch there. He is keeping the strike counters busy tonight.
The counts are high, but it's also the timing at which he lands these strikes. Look at that switch knee. Beautiful switch knee.
Oh, and there's a takedown attempt. Not a great entry there.
Not a great entry. He showed everything he was going to do. He didn't hide his takedown. You knew from the moment this fight started he was going to go get a shot off. The opponent was ready, and he defended it perfectly.
Ooh, looking to go to the leg kick here, just out of range. Stuffs the takedown there. How good is his takedown defense? All right, he engages in the single collar tie.
Big kick. Big clinch. Watch him shift and try to start getting his punches off.
Ooh, now he's got the tie plumb, Daniel. If you're on the other side, what are you trying to do to get out of this potentially dangerous position?
You gotta start digging your shoulder to a side and then try to shove an underhook. You cannot bend down to try to get out of Muay Thai clinch.
Oh, wow! Huge head kick. Huge block.
Oh, man, good stick to the body.
Single collar tie now. And he switches his stance yet again. Oh, good opportunity to do damage here. He's got that tie clinch.
Real quick leg kick.
All right, single collar tie now. Oh, eats a knee. Battling for hooks.
Head kick.
All right, he engages in a single collar tie here. Oh, combination lands, and it seemed like almost every strike found the target.
He's so accurate when he decides to attack. It is a sight to behold.
Oh, stuffs the takedown without issue. Timing his shots nicely here, champ.
He's doing a great job of mixing everything up and using a lot of diverse strikes.
Oh, beautiful jab there. It's one thing to have length, of course. It's another to use it effectively. Beautiful job with that jab. Just misses there with the left.
Nice punch lands over the top.
Oh, nice counter punch there as he continues to make good use of this advantage in reach.
That right hand hurt him a little bit.
Starting to do some really significant damage to the body here. Another strike lands there. And a nice job at least staying upright on that. He's got that right hand going tonight, DC. Connected with it there.
He's thrown so many left jabs. He threw that right punch straight down the pipe. It's unreal.
Oh, he hurt a badly jab.
All right, so we now look back at some of the action from that previous round, DC. A lot of good highlights on both sides.
I mean, a lot of good highlights from both competitors. They both should be very proud of what they accomplished. But I'm telling you, man, I'm not sure they can keep this up. If they land at this clip for another 5 minutes, somebody's going to sleep.
All right, DC, second round is getting underway. Round one, not the round of the year necessarily, but some good in there.
And it's not always going to be. When you have two very talented fighters, sometimes it's very even. That's what we saw in round number one.
DC, didn't take him long to find his range here tonight, huh?
The timing is on point. When you're in a clinch, you can pull down on the head and land these beautiful punches to the head.
Counters with the left hook. Nicely done there. Stuffs the takedown, no problem. Oh, massive head kick there. We'll see if he can finish. And he continues to work the body here.
Look at him chopping the wood. Chop the wood with those leg kicks.
just misses with that one. Ooh. A little single collar tie there. And now he engages in a Muay Thai clinch, and I think a lot of people watching wonder how you can control an opponent like that. Hard to get out of.
It's very difficult to get out of. Look and notice how tight his elbows are as he's maneuvering and moving his opponent.
All right, so a near perfect entry there, and finally he gets his first takedown of the fight, and they say if it's first you don't succeed. Try again, was able to get him down there.
Persistence pays, and that's what we saw with this young man. Over and over, he shot for takedowns, he tried to mix it up, and he got defended. But eventually, he got it done. Now, what does he do with this top control?
How about the speed on that reversal there? I mean, I know you can get out of some bad spots, but it's not with that type of speed.
You cannot allow him to get leverage on the bottom. What a sweep.
All right, bottom fighter here, maybe looking to hip escape, DC.
Oh, high elbow guillotine. Oh, nice guillotine there.
He might get a finish here. Oh, what a beautiful counter to the guillotine there. Gets side mount. Now maybe the Von Flute choke will be there. Ovin St. Preux has got to like that transition there. Take a look back at the replay as he gets it done by submission tonight, champ.
He was able to get the fight to the ground exactly where he wanted it. Eventually, his opponent gave him an opportunity to get a submission. He did that, and he should be very proud of the work he did tonight in the octagon.
So there he is, your winner by submission, and that's exactly how you put the rest of this division on notice. Looks like this guy could be a factor moving forward in this division.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Dan Bergliotta is going to stop this contest at 2 minutes, 29 seconds of round number two. For the winner by submission, Assassin!
Well, the celebration is on in his corner, and hard to blame these guys, sort of waiting to exhale, get a huge win tonight, and not just the win, but they get it by submission.
They knew what they had in front of them. They knew how tough a competitor his opponent was, but they also knew that if they could get this fight to the ground, they could find a submission. They found a submission. He got his hand raised.